What's good, YouTube? Future22J is back at you with another video. I hope everyone is good. I hope everyone is having a great day today. I have the review and the on foot of the Air Jordan 4 Retro I'm on my year while you were sleeping up right now. So make sure you guys go check that video out once you're done with this one. And with this one, I have to say that this is probably the best general released Air Jordan 1 Low Retro, in my personal opinion, this year. But before we get into that, I would like for you guys to take the time out to subscribe to the channel, drop a like on the video, share the video if you like, drop a comment, drop your thoughts, and also make sure that you follow me on Instagram and TikTok at Future22JS. Getting into it, as you guys can see, we have an all-cream Air Jordan 1 box with the navy Nike logos all throughout. Label reads, Air Jordan 1 Retro Low OG. The colorway is Summit White and Gem Red. Here we have the Air Jordan 1 Low OG Howard University. Releasing on October the 12th for the retail price of $140, we finally got ourselves an Air Jordan 1 Low that is considered a PE for a collegiate team. Howard University is a HBCU. Back in 2022, they signed a 20-year deal with the iconic Jordan brand. They also joined a massive powerhouse of teams, such as the Florida Gators, the Oklahoma Sooners, the Houston Cougars, the San Diego State Aztecs, Marquette, Georgetown Hoyas, Michigan Wolverines, UCLA Bruins, and of course, last but not least, North Carolina. Go Heels. Now, this isn't the original Howard PE. The original came in a Chicago style color blocking, and it also had the Howard University logo on the inside of the heel. We didn't get all that, as we never do when it comes down to PEs. They never want to put the logos of the teams on sneakers for general release. We still get the color blocking of the team, and that's good enough for me. So getting into the specs, you can see at the bottom we have an all navy blue Air Jordan 1 outsole. They gave us a sale Air Jordan 1 midsole, clean aspect to add to the Air Jordan 1 lows, in my opinion. All white leather bay. Leather on this sneaker is superb, good to the touch. Now amongst the swoosh and going down the eye stays and around the mud guard, we have this soft pebble navy blue leather. It wrinkles to the touch and it's just super, super smooth. Back heel, we have red leather. We have a cream nylon tongue. Now I really like how they gave us the aged tongue on the sneaker. One, it matches the outsole, and it just gives the shoe just a little bit more aesthetic, in my opinion. Instead of having one stitched item, we have two. A stitched red Nike logo that's near the toe box, and that is the best touch that they can put on any Nike sneaker. Like, it's not even just with the one low. You see it on the Setsuban Dunks. It's just something about that. It makes the sneaker just beautiful. And they also gave us some stitch work on the back heel. The Air Jordan 1 Wings logo stitched in navy blue on the red leather on the back heel. The stitched Jordan 1 Wings logo goes a long way, I promise. Navy blue sock liner with the navy blue insoles, and you can see the red Nike Air on the inside of it. And we also have a red Nike Air on a white patch at the top of the tongue. That sums up the entirety of the sneaker. When it comes down to laces, they come factory lace with a very thick cotton lace. I can't explain it. Once you get the sneaker and touch it, you will see what I mean. And they also come with a spare pair of navy laces as well. I don't care about the navy laces at all. You guys know I love the white laces on Air Jordan 1. It just makes the sneaker look better, in my opinion. But when it comes down to sizing, this is the Air Jordan 1 Low. And for some odd and strange reason, they make the Air Jordan 1 Low toe box just a tad bit longer than the Air Jordan 1 Highs. I don't know why they do it like that. I don't know if it's a construction issue, but that's how it's been for a very long time. Can go a half size down in this sneaker. I am a natural size 12. This is an 11.5. Majority of my Air Jordan 1 low is an 11.5, and the ones that are a 12, which is these Travis Scott's and things like that, I'm trying to get converted to 11.5, but that's a very hard task to do. So I might be stuck with those size 12s, but it's cool with it. But every other Air Jordan 1 low that I've been getting as of recently has been an 11.5, and it has been a perfect fit. I will give these a 9.5 out of 10. Super clean, super versatile. It's not necessarily just for the Howard University, in my opinion. This is a great Team USA sneaker, and best believe the next 4th of July you're going to see this sneaker everywhere, I guarantee. They're sold out on Nike right now, so you might have to go and pay that extra ticket for them. They're not going for any much over retail as of now. These will shoot up, especially around next summer for the 4th of July. And Jordan Brand, if you're listening, need an Air Jordan 1 Low in every single collegiate school that you guys sponsor, especially in North Carolina. This could be the start of something special. Let's keep this going year after year after year. That's the end of the review. My name is Future22JS, and I always know that there's no ceiling to your inner potential. This was my in-hand review of the Air Jordan 1 Low OG in the Howard University colorway. Thank you guys for watching. I'll catch you on the next video. I'm now going to leave you with an on foot so you can see how they look. Be sure to dream with your eyes open, and always remember that your fear ends when your faith begins.